Hello everyone, Dusty here. And in today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys how you can download and back up all of your photos and videos from Google Photos. So basically, there's a couple of ways of doing this. I'm going to show you both ways and you can choose which one you like. But as you can see here, I have a ton of pictures all the way dating back to like 2000. I believe it's like 2014. I've started using Google Photos and I absolutely love it, like you probably do as well. But you may, as I have thought before, what if, you know, something goes wrong or something gets removed or whatever? It's always good to have a backup of a backup, especially when it comes to, say, your kids' photos or, you know, photos of important events or outings or whatever it may be. And so today I'm going to show you how to make sure that you can download and back those files up. So go to a website called takeout.google.com. If you just search for Google takeout.google, it'll take you to this page here, but you can look at the URL where I'm at here in the upper left-hand corner of my screen. Then you're going to be presented with something here that says your account, your data, and then down below you're going to see all of the different things that you can download. Now obviously we don't want to download our Chrome history, we don't want to download our search history or any of that. All we're looking for today is our Google Photos. So what we want to do is deselect all of those, because naturally they're going to be all selected because Google thinks you want to download everything apparently, and then scroll down until you see something that says Google Photos. They're alphabetically ordered, so go down to where you see Google Photos and then click the check mark there. Now you're going to see a couple of different options here. You're going to see multiple formats and you're going to see all photo albums included. Now if you click the multiple formats, it's basically telling you that whatever native format that the photos or videos are in on Google Photos, that's how they're going to be downloaded. So if they're a JPEG, they're going to download as a JPEG. If they're a PNG file, it's going to download as a PNG file. Also, the same goes for videos, because we're downloading them as well. If they are an MP4 or a .mov or a .flv, whatever they are, that actual format will be the one that is downloaded. As far as the metadata that's associated with those photos and videos, that will be attached to them as well when they're downloaded. So that's basically, it's telling you that right there. Now, right here where it says all photo albums included. Now, as you can tell, I have a ton of albums. We can scroll down and you can see here every month since I believe late 2014, 5 years ago, is going to be on here. Now, you may have less or you may have more photos than me. It really doesn't matter. Basically, all you're allowed to do here is you can select the months or the albums that you've created within Google Photos that you want to download. So let's say you want to piecemeal it together. You only want to download a few of the albums that you have, you can go here and select the ones that you want. Obviously, we can deselect all of them just like we did earlier and then select the actual individual albums that we want to download. Now, I may do that for the purposes of this tutorial, but obviously, I'm showing you how to download all of your photos and videos. So basically, you want to select all and then basically click the OK button here. And that's how you want to do it. Now, for me in this video, I'm not going to download all of that. If you did select a couple of albums, like I only selected one here, you'll see where it says one photo album selected. Otherwise, it will say all albums selected. Now, once we have done that, we want to scroll all the way to the bottom of this screen and then go to the blue button here that says next step. Once we've done that, we're going to be able to customize the way that we're going to download and archive these files. Now, since you're going to have probably a whole bunch of files, this is very important. So basically the delivery method, how do you want these files delivered to you? You can add them to your drive, you can add them to your Dropbox, OneDrive, to your box, or the way that I select is send download link via email. It's easier that way. Now the file type that you want to choose is definitely .zip. Now again, if you want to do TGZ, I've never dealt with that. That's on you, okay? I would recommend doing zip files. It's very much easy. It's very much easier to extract all the files once it's downloaded. I would go with zip. The archive size, again, you can choose anything from 1 gig to 50 gig. Now, what I recommend you doing is doing multiple zip files in, say, 4 gig or 10 gig increments. So maybe choose 4 gig in size, and then that will, basically what it says is if it's anything larger than that, it'll split it up into multiple files. So basically, once it reaches that cap size of whatever you want it to be, it'll then start over and say, you know, folder two, folder three, once it reaches the actual cap size that you set it at here. Now, once you're ready, go ahead and click the blue button here that says Create Archive. Now, basically, it'll tell you the progress here. An archive of your Google Photos data is currently being prepared. Basically, you can cancel it if you've done something wrong, or if you want to do something in the meantime, you can create another archive if you want to go back and select. Now, as you can tell, as we were talking, it downloaded that folder, those photos that I actually already told it to do. Now, what I want to do now is I can click the download button here, or I can go to my Gmail and I'm going to have an email that looks like this. So as you can see, it says your Google Data Archive is ready, your account, your data, just like that there. And then you can click the blue download archive button, and then you'll probably have to sign in to your Gmail or Google account. And then once you're ready, click the blue button and it automatically does it for you. Now, if we click the file that we just downloaded, as you can see here, it's titled Takeout. And again, if there's multiple folders, it will be titled, you know, Takeout 1, Takeout 2. And you can do this on Windows, Mac, Linux, it really doesn't matter. And then click the folder there and then go to Google Photos, and then it's going to show you the exact day that you selected there. And as you can see, all of my images, which again, there's not very many of them here, are going to be downloaded directly to my computer. Now, there's another way of doing this. We can go to our Google Photos and we can select specific photos. Like we can select, say if you want to do it by month or by day, let's say I wanted to download all of yesterday's images. Just select them by checking the box there and then shift clicking down to where you want to download, and then go up to where you see the three dots where it says more options, and then go to download, or you can click shift D. It really doesn't matter if you want to do that on your keyboard. And then once you're ready, it'll download a photos.zip down below. And if we click that there and then open up those photos, as you can see, all of those photos and movies will be opened on my computer. Now, if you have any questions about how to do any of this, please put that in the comment section below. And just remember, if you're trying to download the entire library of your Google Photos, which is what you're probably doing if you're watching this video, make sure when you're here at the Google Photos page here on the takeout.google.com that you've actually selected all of the albums. Make sure you haven't gone through and deselected some and selecting certain albums. You want to make sure that you've selected all of them, and then you are good to go. Thank you guys, as always, for watching my videos, and I will talk to you guys in the next one.